Welcome back, Spacer here. So, in today's video, we finally got the cover reveal for Diary of a Wicked Book 17, or Die for Overworld, as it's being called, a few days ago. In today's video, I'm going to be going over every information that we got so far about this book and speculating on what this book is going to be about. And so, with that said, let's begin. And this cover, just to confirm your skepticism as to whether or not this is real or not, it's not fake. That was made by someone for an LLB. And if you look at the Amazon fudge for this, this is indeed the real deal. As for the cover's design in itself, most people, myself included, complained about the design, where on one hand it has the black shiny hexagon texture on it, which looks nice, and then there's what appears to be a speaker that has his opacity just lowered. And with these two aspects in mind, it makes the cover a little bit too crowded and complicated than it has to be, which make it look a bit out of place when you consider that Diary of a Wicked has a similar design philosophy to this book. There were also alternate versions for this cover that were posted by Jeff Kinney on Twitter the following day. One of them has Greg standing over the two speakers in the same pose, another one with Greg carrying said speakers with Roderick sitting on top of them. And looking at all these images side by side, I honestly much preferred the one that included Roderick much better than the other two. Hopefully this is not the final cover that we ended up getting when you consider that this book is also going to be focused around Roderick. And so including him into the cover seems to make sense to me. But in any case, reading the synopsis for it on Amazon, it reads, Greg Capullo is finding out that the road to fame and glory comes with some hard knocks. When he decides to tag along with his brother Roderick's band Wally Diaper, Greg doesn't realize what he's getting himself into. But he soon learns that the late nights, unpaid gigs, fighting between band members, and money troubles are all part of the rock and roll lifestyle. Can Greg help Wally Diaper become the legend they think they are? Or will too much time with Roderick's band will be a Diaper overload? So what I find interesting about this synopsis is that, believe it or not, it was actually changed after they replaced the teaser image on Amazon for the actual cover, which was actually fortunately was documented and archived in the fandom wiki for the page for the book before someone has to edit and replace it after the cover reveal with the new version of the synopsis, which you should be seeing on screen right now. But in a nutshell, the thing that you should pay attention to with this old version of the synopsis that I've noticed is that it's going to partially be another road trip book for the fourth time in the series. So onto the speculation and prediction section of this video. There's a teaser image released for this book on Twitter, which includes a guitar or bass pin with the number 17 on it, which presumably is going to be included as a preview in the exclusive edition for this book. Yes, in case you didn't know, they actually do make them for each release of a new book. But finding one is going to be a bit difficult if you intend on buying this version. But anyways, going back into synopsis, as to why Roderick and his band Wally Diaper is going to be on a road trip with Greg, we don't exactly know. And the only way I could see this possibly working is if Wally Diaper were part of a traveling convention where they would be performing in a band competition which required them to be moving from place to place. Which could mean we could possibly see Wally Diaper or the Hepleys using the RV again from the deep end, rather than using the band that Roderick uses or the mini band that the Hepleys has. So assuming what I said about it being a convention wind up being true when the book comes out, then there's a possibility that Rowley would appear in this book, or at the very least had a relevant role in the plot. One way they could see Jeff could spin it is the reason why Rowley is going to this convention is because Josh is going to be performing there. But the catch being, because this is Diary of a Wimpy Kid after all, the place where Josh is going to be performing is going to be in a separate area in the convention, which also solves the problem that Rowley's dad is going to prevent him from attending this event. Either that, or there are other ways to have him be involved in this book's plot is by having him tag along with Greg as a roadie for Wally Diaper, which has a decent chance of happening, especially when the third movie Dog Days did this. Also, the title Diaper Overworld is a reference to a song lyrics featured in the Do It Yourself book, specifically the second iteration released in 2011 that includes additional activities, which features a section from Roderick where the same name appeared as the title for a song lyrics, which on screen right now you should be seeing the page for it from the Do It Yourself book. Now, obviously, we won't hear this book being sung in the actual book itself because, you know, this is a book. But instead, we would probably hear this being performed in the new Disney Plus animated Roderick Rose readaptation, much like how they did it and executed it in the live action movie. But with that said, that's all the news that I have for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and find it informative, please leave a like. If you want to see more videos like this, consider subscribing. But with that said, this is Spacer signing out.